Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Perfect. Do you guys hear me good? Do you understand me well? Perfect. I'm super, super excited and extremely honored to be here and share the stage with so many amazing speakers. I don't know who did the schedule, but whoever did the schedule kind of wanted to put me in a bad position, because speaking after Mohammed now, I don't even know what value I can add, because what he's doing, I think, is the biggest and most amazing thing we can do as human beings. On the first hand, I believe we should all take care of ourselves first, because if you don't take care of yourself, you can't take care of other people. If you're not happy, you can't make other people happy. If you're not inspired, you can't inspire other people. But the next most important thing we should do as human beings is give our hand in hand, amazing name, and reach out to other people who need our help, but who are also willing to accept our help. Because at the end of the day, every point where we are in life right now, every point where you are in these seats, or like maybe people watching a video of this speech, the point where you are right now is based on your own feelings, your thoughts, which turn into your words, which turn into your actions, which turn into your character, which shapes your destiny. So the reason why we are at the point where we're at right now is because of ourselves. And that's the most important message I want to give to you. The major key to your better future is you. Nobody else. And that's what I realized at, luckily, a very young age, that we have to be the change that we want to see in this world. Many people, no matter where they come from, where they live, what social or like what background at all, we like to blame somebody else for our problems. You know, when people would make a list of all the reasons why they are not where they want to be, they would put maybe the government, taxes, their boss, their parents, their best friends, their school, their professors, their teachers. You know, we like to blame other people for our own mishappenings, but at the end of the day, it's always myself who's responsible for my future. And that's something, guys, please take this serious, because if we realize this, we can help change an entire planet by not blaming somebody else, but actually taking responsibility. So I've had the honor, 5 years ago, I started doing online marketing, trading, investing, and just finding ways to not be stuck in the situation where I was from. I'm from a very small village in Germany with like 3,000 people living there, and I always wanted to travel the world. Like, just me being here and having the honor to speak in front of you guys, meeting so many new people, making new friends, and really getting to know the culture here in Egypt is one of my biggest motivations when I started this journey 5 years ago. And in those 5 years, especially the last 3 years, because the first 2 years I was working all day, every day, had no time for nothing, I've been traveling the world. I've been on basically every continent besides Antarctica. And I realize one important thing. No matter where we go, people are always the same. And I don't mean we don't always look the same, but in our heart, like our being, what we really are, we're the same. We love our families, we love our friends. We want to have time for the beautiful things in life. We want to walk around and just have enough of everything. We want to have enough food on the table to take care of ourselves and our family. We want to have a roof to like sleep well. You know, we want to take care. We want to maybe go on some vacations, have some nice stuff. But no matter where we go, no matter where I went, from Thailand all the way to Colombia or Mexico, people are the same, and that's what we have to realize. We're not in this against each other, you know, nations, and that's what this conference is for, like bringing people together, bringing civilizations together, or at least that's how I see it, and like understanding that we're all the same and we can work together and create a much better future. And that's where technology comes into place. You know, that's what I realized, luckily at a very young age, when I was 20, 21, that people on YouTube, Instagram, whatever, I was one of those guys who was sitting at their job being like, not happy about my job, not satisfied, no nothing, because I wasn't excited and passionate about it. And I was on Instagram, I was on Facebook, and I was seeing these people living their dream lives, and I was like, why are they having this type of life? And why am I sitting in my small village and I'm not really happy? And I realized it's the things that I'm doing, I wasn't passionate. I'm a high school dropout, I never went to college. And from like formal education, most of you guys are much smarter than I am. But what I learned and what I realized is, like 150, 200, 500 or 1,000 years ago, the one who had the most power, the one who had the most force, was the most successful. Then it changed. And in the last 20 to 100 years, the one with the best knowledge and the best education was winning and advancing. But now, in this day, the fourth industrial revolution and the digital age, it's all about adapting. It's about adapting to new circumstances. And I realized, okay, there's people, there's boys, who are making over $20 million per year just opening toys. And I'm like, oh my God. You know, like most people work their entire life and they don't even make $1 million. And this guy is just, he's having fun, you know, he's doing what he actually enjoys. And it blew my mind. And once your mind is expanded, once your mind is stretched, it can never go back. But you obviously have to understand and believe it, you know. And through technology, on the one hand, it's going to bring us a lot of good things, but it's also going to bring obstacles. Jobs are falling away, but also jobs will be created, like you see in the middle image. You know, like a few years ago, filming a movie scene of like the skyline in New York, there was two people who had a job, the pilot and the cameraman. Now, both people lose their jobs because of drones. And it's not necessarily a bad thing, it's just facts, you know, because we had many industrial revolutions, and it's not like all the jobs were away and every one of us is unemployed. It's like a blessing and a curse, you know, it's bringing opportunities, and just like the last 5,000 years, I believe that's how it's going to be the next 50 years, that society and the world is obstacles and challenges mixed with opportunities, and it's about us to take these opportunities and make something out of it, you know? And also, what in the next 10, 15, 20 years, I don't know, I'm not an expert, but I learn a lot from experts, is that about 50, 60, 55% of all the jobs that we humans do right now will be outsourced to robots, to artificial intelligence, and there will be a new kind of technology and age coming, and it's important to understand that we have to adapt. When we're scared of the future, we can't really create the future. We have to work on our feelings, and we have to work on our perception of the future, because our perception of the future is realer than reality itself. You know, and I got this article from Forbes, which talks a little bit about like how the future of the economy through the digitalization and like all these technologies will happen. We will have a lot more people with not full-time jobs working for one company for the rest of their life, but people will have opportunities to work many different things. For example, Uber and Lyft, the gig economy, where people can take their phone, log into their Uber application and drive people to the airport and make some additional income. You know, people like myself or Dennis, my videographer and content creator, who's doing marketing, he's doing content creation, but he's also trading, so he's sitting in front of his laptop and making a couple hundred extra dollars every week from trading. You know, it's like mixing together the world and the economy will change a lot, but it will change for the better if we accept that it will change for the better. We will have a lot of decentralization. You know, back in the days, everything was controlled, very, very strict, but now it's going to be more free-flowing because technology will be available all over the world. And one of the most crazy things which I didn't know, but I talked to one of the guys here in the front, and he's in the PAP leadership program of the Egyptian government, and they told me that over 60% of the people here in Egypt don't have any access to banking. You know, and there's technologies already out there, you probably heard about it, Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, and all those things which give people who have no access to banking right now the opportunity to go into these economies, to have access to the banking world worldwide, and to be have access to the communities. And I think that's very, very important because, for example, I know many people in Germany or the United States, they came from a different country, they work and they want to send money back to their families, but then they have like 10-15% in fees, or they don't know if the money really arrives with their family. So this will change and will bring a lot of change for the future. And also, like my generation, I'm 25 years old right now, we want to experience the world different. We want to learn, we want to grow. You heard it from the two amazing speakers before me. Like, our generation is different. You know, my mom's generation, they just wanted to survive and have a good life. My grandpa's generation, he was struggling to get by after the World War and like basically taking food out of the trash to survive. But our generation right now, my generation, we grew up with technology, but we still grew up with the old ways. And we just want to learn, we want to improve, we want to do something we're excited and passionate about. It's important to really find ways to do that. So rather than thinking about the future and being scared that 50-60% of the current jobs will fall away, because that's what's going to happen in the United States, there's already restaurants where there's no human worker. There's robots making the food, cleaning the kitchen, and serving the food. And you know how it is, like maybe some people like to cook, but nobody really likes to clean after the cooking. You know, robots don't care, artificial intelligence don't care, the way you program them, that's the way they work. So it's basically like also an extra arm for our society and for us humans to create what we really, really want to create. So instead of looking negatively to the future, it's important to look positively to the future. Because like I said in the beginning, your feelings, your thoughts, your words, and your actions put you in the situation where you're at right now. And how you feel in this present moment is how you're going to create the future. So imagine you had all the tools in the world to create your future, to create your dream life. Would you want it to be negative, or would you want it to be positive? And the same way, you should take care of your thoughts, because every thought that we have will grow into something, like a seed. Like the seed of a tree will grow into another tree, which will bring fruits. You know, and that's very important, because if we understand how our thoughts work, then we can create the future in a very amazing way. And I've learned this from my mentor. He's teaching like many successful people in Hollywood, in the United States, royal families. And I was lucky to meet him randomly when I was 5,000 euro in debt. I hated my job. I lost my job, actually. And I was like at the lowest level of my life, emotionally, financially. Me and my ex-girlfriend broke up. I was just at this point where you're like, okay, might as well, if I'm gone, I'm gone. You know, I don't really care. And that's when I met him, and I understand that mostly in your most miserable days, you will get the seed for your better future. You know, and everything that you can see, everything that you can touch, just look around in this room, everything that you can see and everything you can touch was first a thought. Even yourself. You were a thought of your parents. You were a seed of your parents. The clicker that I have right here, somebody had the idea to create this, then they were drawing it out, then they created a prototype, then they started selling this, and now this prototype is here. And it's a functional product. So everything that we want in this world, it's already out there. First in the imaginary inner world, and then we can create it in the outer world. Just like Steve Jobs created the iPhone. Now it's normal for us, but 20, 25 years ago, this is not normal, the type of technology that we have right now. If we go 100 years back in time, and you would go with an iPhone, they would kill you right away and say you're a magician or you're a witch, and they would burn you. But now it's normal. If we go 200 years back and we would show people light and electricity, they would think it's not impossible. So our thoughts really create the future. And a belief is just a thought that we keep thinking, that we keep believing. And once we keep having the same thought every single day, no matter what, you decide what that thought is and how you want to create your future. I'm not here to create your future. I'm here to help you and give you some insights of what I've been able to learn the last 5 years. So once we keep thinking that thought, it becomes a belief, it attaches to us personally. And once it attaches to us personally, we put in emotion. And emotions are the strongest thing in the world. You can't really see it, you can't really touch it, but we can all feel it. And the best feeling in the world is love. And when we're able to use these emotions, attach it to our thoughts, we can create anything in the world, because that's how we manifest whatever we want in life. And that's the beauty that we have. It's important that we have the right values, because now, understanding that we have the key to the future, what values do we want to bring into this future? What values do we want to bring into our family? What values do we want to bring into our communities? It's the most important thing. It's the most beautiful thing. And I believe what you guys can do to really take a small thing from what I said and put it into action for the next couple of weeks, for the next couple of months, especially after this amazing event. I mean, I've been at the Freedom-y yesterday, and I've seen like the energy and the power and the knowledge that was put into this event. But I've been at many events in my life. I've spoken at many events, and mostly people are excited at these events. They learn something new, they go home, and they don't change. But change is the most important thing to actually get there. You have to make a decision to change. So please, if you want to take something from my speech and you want to create your future different than your past, once you get home, once you're settled in and it gets quiet, just sit down, maybe sit on the terrace, on the balcony of your hotel, and write down what you want for your future. Because you can create it. The next 5 years, anything can change, and you won't recognize your life and you won't recognize yourself. But if you don't know where you want to be 5 years from now, you're already there and you're not going to go where you might want to go. So please take the time, really find out what you wish and what you desire, because desire is the first step of achievement. And when you have desire and the will to change, we can create anything in this world, whatever we want, no matter how crazy everybody else thinks it is. And I hope you really take this to heart. I've learned this from my mentors, and I want to pass it on to you guys. So thank you for taking the time. It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you for the invitation, and have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.